on, guys. We get here, workingclassfitness.com. And, I got a really interesting question here about a week or so ago via email that I wanted to talk about. A 14-year-old kid emailed me and wanted to know what a good MMA chest workout was. And, you know, when I responded back to him, I told him, really, there was no such thing. Well, I take that back. There is such a thing, but there really shouldn't be. And by that, what I mean is that you shouldn't be looking to, if you are truly interested in MMA, either as a fighter, because you want to climb into the cage and eventually compete, or you want to, you know, do some BJJ competitions, or, you know, you're just, even just a regular guy that wants to be in fighting type shape, you know, strong and conditioned, and, you know, the physique and the whole nine yards. You shouldn't be looking at trying to isolate your muscles and say, okay, what's a good chest workout, you know, or what's a good, you know, arm workout or back workout or anything else like that. You know, what you should be doing is saying, okay, how can I improve those qualities that will improve my MMA? You know, what is it that the chest provides, let's say, to your MMA? You know, it's, you know, a big muscle group. It'll, you know, allows you to move in certain movement patterns, allows you to do certain things. It provides a certain amount of strength. Take a look at those things and say, how do I improve that? For instance, you know, chest is a muscle that's used mainly in pressing movements in the horizontal plane, i.e., you know, perpendicular to your body. The vertical plane would obviously be overhead press, you know, parallel to your body, that sort of a thing. So when you say, all right, what do I, you know, what do I want to do there? Say, okay, don't just say, oh, well, what's a good chest workout for MMA? Say, how can I get my chest stronger? Well, you will never get your chest, let's say, stronger or bigger by itself. You will always be using something else in congruence. You know, because you don't want to be doing isolation movements, because there's no sort of isolation being done in the cage anyway. You'll never run into a time where you say, oh, well, I'm only ever using my chest, or I'm only ever using my biceps, or whatever. Everything always ends up being used together. So when you go to the gym, you should be treating that the same way. You know, exercises that will integrate, you know, the chest and the shoulders and the arms and everything else. You know, a bench press will work your chest, shoulders, and triceps. Dips work your chest and your triceps. Even your overhead presses will work the chest indirectly. Push-ups will work, you know, the chest and the triceps and the shoulders some. So look at getting better at those type of movements as a whole, getting stronger, being able to do more reps, that sort of a thing. Don't look at saying, oh, well, what's a good MMA chest routine? Because then you've got to have an MMA shoulder routine, an arm routine, MMA leg routine, all that other kind of stuff. And when you don't, all you really need to do is just say, hey, how can I get my upper body pressing up? How can I get better at overhead press? How can I, you know, do more weight for weighted dips, do more push-ups? You do that, and everything else will just take care of itself. So hope that helps. If there's any other kind of videos you'd like me to create, let me know. I've got another video, because I'm doing a whole ton of these. I've got another video coming up at the very end of this. You'll see a thing, you know, box, there'll be a screenshot of it. You can click on that link. You can check out another one of my videos, or there's actually a link underneath this in the description. Click that link, and that'll take you to another video you can check out as well. So do that, and we'll talk to you soon. Train hard, rest hard, play hard.